and Miles, estranged from his oldest sons, found fatherhood easier with his youngest son, Erin, who shared his interest in music.
I think about him every day, really, especially when I'm working on music or when I hear something and I hear some music and I start thinking about it. Then I go, wait, I'm kind of thinking like he would think about that, or I've heard him think. You know, I would never know exactly what he was thinking about any piece of music, but I start analyzing things differently and I go, oh, I must have got that. Yeah. I guess as a father, there's a piece, I think it's called New Blues. That's one I listen to when I just think about him as a father, as a person, just as, you know, my father. Because I used to visit him once a month in Malibu, and I thought it'd be great to live here. And then I got in so much trouble in school that he decided that I had to come live with him. I can't tell you how many times that I'd gone to the store with either Vince or Mike and gotten paints and canvases and brushes and cleaned the brushes and cleaned the bowls of paint.
If you're sketching and you have the paper, the feel of the paper turns me on and makes me sketch different things.
Did you get angry?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's the side you didn't want to see. You know, you got to be cool.
For a brief period, Erin joined his father on the road.
I did a summer tour, which is about 2.5 months, and I did a fall tour, which is about a month and a half. That was enough for me. See?
Superstar.
Just hamming it up. This is a cool bit right here.